I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Anymore.
The homeless man. One day, Yaya was walking with his mum after picking him up from school. As they were walking down the path, they saw a homeless man of about 40 years old. He was sitting on the sidewalk with a puppy sleeping on his lap. Several seconds after they walked past him, Yaya stopped and asked his mum, "Mom, is he hungry? Can we buy him and the puppy something to eat?" Yaya's mom felt compassion and empathy and told Yaya, "Sure, why not?" Then they walked together to a sandwich restaurant that was a couple of blocks away and bought two sandwiches and walked back to where we saw the man and his puppy and gave him those sandwiches, and he gave one of those sandwiches to his puppy. He was very grateful and said, "Thank you very much, kind people. God will surely reward you." Yaya and his mum then left. They were living a couple of miles away. After getting home that very day, Yaya asked the mum, "Mum, can we make extra dinner tomorrow?" "Why, Yaya?" Mummy asked. He then told his mum that he wanted to give some to the homeless man and his puppy so that they wouldn't be hungry. Yaya's mum was so touched by his request, and she quickly replied, "Yes." However, the next day, Yaya got to that same place he saw the homeless man and his puppy, but this time around, he didn't see them. They were gone. After school, Yaya's mum came to pick him up, but she noticed that Yaya was very sad and unhappy. "Yaya, why are you sad? What happened, sweetie? Is everything okay?" Yaya's mum asked. Yaya then replied, "Mum, I got to that spot we saw the man and his puppy, but I didn't see them," he said sadly. Yaya's mum then smiled and said, "Even though we weren't able to give them the food we made, I am so proud of you." Yaya was only 4 years old, and that was the first time he asked his mum to buy him something, and what he asked for was meant for the stranger and his puppy. Yaya has never asked his mum to buy toys or video games, because he knows his mum doesn't make much money. At a very young age, Yaya was filled with compassion and empathy. Yaya's mum, being a single mother, always worried about raising her son well, but now she believes Yaya will grow up to be a great man someday. Moral lesson. We all have to show compassion to one another. We get the rewards of our helpful acts in return. If we grow with compassion and empathy, the world will be a better place.
Good morning, everyone. Our devotion today is "His Time, Not Mine."
In Hebrews 11:1, it says, "Now faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see." Some years ago, my family joined a new larger church, and I didn't know anyone at first, and I asked God to provide new friends for me. God did provide some great friends eventually, but I can't say he came through exactly the way I asked him to. It took almost 2 years to start making solid friendships. But part of faith is being certain of what we do not see. For the longest time, I didn't see God working. But now I have many good Christian friends, and I can look back and see that he was there helping me all along. Sometimes it's hard to trust God and have the patience to wait for him. Remember how I told you that God doesn't work on our time, but works on his? When I feel like God isn't listening, that's when I need to take verses like this one seriously. If I have faith in God's plan for me, he will see my faith and work everything out in his time. That's the key. We got to remember that one. So why does God sometimes make us wait for our answers to prayers? I'd like you to have that conversation with someone today. Me, a friend, a family member, somebody. Think about some Bible characters who had to wait a long time before God answered their prayers. People like Abram and Joseph, Job, and others. What can you learn from their stories? I hope you take some time today to think about that. And as you go through your day, be better today than you were yesterday.
Take in a deep breath, and as you breathe out, feel your body begin to relax. Now imagine that you are sitting in a beautiful garden. There is no one else around to bother or disturb you. It's your special place. It's a lovely day, blue sky, soft breeze, warm but comfortable. You feel so peaceful and relaxed in this beautiful garden. And you look down to your left, and you see in the grass there are flowers, deep red, bright orange blossoms, just so beautiful, so colorful. And there are bushes around you with yellow flowers that look like bells. And there are blue and lavender flowers in bushes and in the grass all around you. There are trees, beautiful trees, full of blossoms of white and pink. Full green, beautiful trees. And you feel so peaceful, calm and relaxed. This beautiful garden all around you. And there is the fragrance of nature on the breeze. You feel comfortable and calm. You can hear the birds in the trees, the sound of the breeze rustling the leaves. And all around you is peace and tranquility. And you feel calm and centered. And when you are ready, you will take a deep breath, and as you breathe out, just have a gentle stretch, whatever feels comfortable for you right now. Just like a cat waking up in the morning, you are feeling energized now and confident, but still deeply relaxed and ready to enjoy a beautiful day.